Hey everyone, welcome back for a little TLC. We're still talking about friendship, and so I invited my good friend Bradley Burton to come on and talk with us. Today's topic is opposite sex friendship. Can men and women just be friends? Let's get into it.
You got what I need, but you say he just a friend, and you say he just a friend. Oh, baby!
Thank you so much for joining me. I'm so happy to have with me one of my good friends, Bradley Burton. He is in Chicago, so that's why we're going to have to do this Zoom call. Bradley, you want to introduce yourself real quick?
No, you're not. Hey, what's up? My name is Bradley Burton from North Carolina. I work with the Chicago Sky, the senior designer there. And we're in Chicago right now, you know. Still trying to get to the summertime. It's cold, but I'm happy that I'm actually ready for this conversation today.
Okay, I'm glad you're excited. So as everyone knows, we're talking about opposite sex friendship. Can men and women just be friends? So what's your initial thought when I asked you that, Bradley?
My initial thought, can men and women be friends? Me personally, I think we can. I think there's a few situations that messes up things, but I believe like we can. And sometimes that situation is brought up in a relationship, and that's just like a ruler stick of what she's gonna be handling in the situation.
So. Okay, I guess I should have started off by saying, so Bradley and I are really good friends. How long have we been friends since?
We've been friends since the 10th grade homeroom.
Okay, so since about 2008 or so.
Hey.
Well, I've kept you around for a long time. Lucky you. So, yeah, we're really good friends. So I think it doesn't surprise me for you to say that you think that it's possible, but you did say that there are a few instances where it might not be possible. So can you talk about those times?
Man, so when that happens, I don't bring up I have female friends to, I guess, probably the wrong time where, let's say, like, you text me or Todd texts me. When Todd texts me, it's kind of great because she's married. So I'll be like, it's my homegirl, like, it's my sister, like, she married, you know? Like, and then my girl who I'm talking to at the time was like, yeah. But, like, I always kind of, like, slowly invite that, because I don't want, you know, y'all too to know every girl I'll be with when I'm dating them, because y'all kind of like, we have deep dive conversations, and I don't want, you know, like, I want to mature, like, the mature relationships or whatever I have, like, that's come to your doorsteps. But
okay, because you know we will play you if you bring anybody around.
I've learned not to let y'all know every chick.
Wait, so you said that, okay, you won't mention that you have female friends, and then it becomes awkward when, like, one of us texts you.
Me personally don't become awkward.
Okay.
Maybe to her it might be, but at the end of the day, it's like, I'll be in my head be thinking, like, these might be the chicks that are probably trying to save your life. Like, they might be like, I should stick with you, you know? But, like, most of the time, it even like it's you or Todd or my homegirls from like Marcel, like Angela, A&T. Like, most of the time, like, if I have a question that I need to ask, or if I don't think I'm messing up, then I might let y'all know. But you know, at the same time, it's like, how is she looking if a girl is texting me? But be honest with you, none of y'all call me like after 10 or 9, you go to bed around 6. So it's not like people, it's not like I get late phone calls like now since we're out of school.
Okay, now I get that. So first of all, I heard you try to shout out A&T, talking about one of your friends from there. You ain't slick.
Let me tell you, Aggie Pride.
You are not slick. But I am wondering though, do you think it would be less awkward if you just from the jump were like, hey, I have these three really close female friends?
From the jump, they don't even know my middle name.
Okay.
Like, I'm not, I'm not letting you get that far until like I'd be like, all right, I feel like we can build something. There's not that many. I haven't had that many relationships like that went deep. Like, I only had one that went a year. I don't know how that happened. Like, my relationship is like Carmelo in the playoffs. Like, I'm first round and that's it.
Oh my gosh.
Like, dating for me, it's been horrible. Not like horrible, but like, it's just been like, ah. But I think like the more and more I grow up, I get a little serious that I don't want to be that older person in the club, like trying to pick up younger chicks. So I'm trying to like.
Please don't be that person in the club. We will give you the side eye.
I'm trying not to, but it's looking like I'm going to be in there with my mask on.
Okay. So question, has you having female friends impacted any of your relationships in the past?
Yes. Yes. You and Todd. Yeah. We'll text, we'll have a group chat, we'll talk about the situation, and then usually you'd be like, Bradley or Raggedy. That's her phrase. But some of them conversations I really thought about, I really looked at it and was like, maybe I wasn't tripping, or maybe I was tripping. And then I guess from there, it's what I decided to do, how I try to figure it out. Oh, yeah. Well,
would you say that you having female friends makes you a better boyfriend sometimes?
I think you need female friends. I think because your guy friend's going to tell you lies. Like, they're me. They're going to tell you some stupid stuff. It's one time where I trusted my, I think it was a year ago. I went with what my guy was saying. Mm-hmm. And he was like, so the thing was like, I was going to go over there, right? And I was going to, after the argument, I was going to like say, hey, he was like, no, you should like spend the night. And I was like, I don't think it's a great idea. And he was like, no, like if she lets you know, like you can come over there and you're like, you sleep on the couch. Like, no, I'm sleeping in the bed. I was like, all right. So we text. And she was like, yeah, you can sleep on the couch. And I was like, no, I sleep in the bed. When I tell you, she gave me a few choice words. And that was my last time I took his advice. And I was like, guys are stupid.
You didn't ask us anything about that. And that's why you got fussed out that day.
That was my last time listening to him. He's a lawyer. That's my last one.
No, I'm just kidding. Okay. Have any of your girlfriends ever wanted you to cut me and Ty off?
Yeah. They do. Have to go into specifics. No. They have. I'll probably say two or three. One recently, and I think if we continue to talk or whatever happens, then I'll just bring her around. I mean, that's all. I always let her know, like, bro, if you understand our relationship, you would know, like, they don't want me. Yeah, they majority of the time be saving me off the cliff. Like, if you see, but I feel like if I was in that situation, and like I would know her friends, like if she didn't have no dude guy friends, I'd probably worry.
Okay.
And I'm not that type of person to be like, you can't have guy friends. You have to have like, you have to have that balance.
You talked a little bit about you would bring them around if they felt uncomfortable with you having female friends. Is there anything that we can do to make your girlfriends feel more comfortable? Or is there anything more you think you could do to make them feel more comfortable?
just stop calling me and texting me.
You just gotta stop talking to you altogether. Friendship done.
Look, like I told you yesterday, I'll save your number under like a different number, like T-Mobile. Like, dang, my phone bill already in? Like, you know, but no, I think like I don't know, because you're I picked, like, we became friends. Like, we picked each other as friends. We picked each other as friends to stay along in life because of certain things. Like, I have trust and love for both of y'all. Like, I have trust and love for me. Like, I don't want you to change, because if you're doing what I want you to do, it's not going to end up. It's not going to end up good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that's true. So you talked about how, like, our friendship, we have, like, boundaries. So I don't call you after a certain time of night. Todd doesn't call you after a certain time of night. Are there other boundaries that we could have in place to make other people feel more comfortable, or to make it seem like we really are just friends?
No, I just sometimes just like mention you in a story, whatever, or like I say, hey, like, this is Erica, whatever. And like just a few minutes ago, like when I was doing the letterhead, like design a letterhead, like she heard of you and like was kind of like iffy, but like I think she understood, like, we kind of got like a relationship, like a friendship, like, we, bro, I trust this, you know what I mean? So it's like, I think just easing the person into the situation where they don't feel bombarded or like caught off guard with the thing. Like, I've seen so many times, like, people will hide their best friend like they, like it's another girlfriend.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Or like, or like they'll come over, like they'll be hanging together and they come over to see his chick or whatever, and he's like, you know, because everybody, I mean, if you, even if you don't say, but everybody is insecure about something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I think part of my job as one of your female friends is to do what I can to not make that person feel insecure, or at least let them know that they don't have to be insecure about me. So, is your girlfriend over there right now?
No, that's the game.
Okay, tell me anything, because I'd be more than happy to meet her. You know me. I'll be like, just give me one conversation. You'll know that I do not want your man. I don't want him. So I am wondering. So like we've never dated or anything. Even when I came to see you in Chicago, I stayed at a hotel. Like, there was no confusing anything. So do you think that we would be able to be friends if we had ever dated in the past?
To be honest with you, I don't really be friends with my ex.
Okay, why is that?
Or like, I done messed up things so bad, and like she don't want to talk to me. And that's where a majority of it is.
Okay, so you be out here blowing it, and so that's,
I probably got some girls right now with a picture of my face on a voodoo doll. Like, yeah,
man, you be blowing it, man.
I be blowing it. I mean, it's like, what you live and you learn, though. Like, I'd rather blow it right now.
Okay.
In my youth years, to before I even like think about marriage or like having kids. Like, I don't want to blow the kids either.
Yeah. No, that's very real. So you think that you would have just blown it, and that's why we wouldn't be friends?
I would have blown it. Yeah, I would. I'm not gonna lie.
It just is what it is. I think that's true.
Something would have happened.
Okay. But we don't really have to worry about it because we didn't date. So are you friends with any of your exes?
Like, we talk here and there, and they you know, text me, how you doing? But like, nah, I don't. Because we'll be friends, and I'm kind of like a cool type person. And then they'll start talking about their boyfriend or whatever, and I don't want to hear that.
Okay.
Like, I don't wanna.
Wow.
I think I'm cool with one.
Okay. You're cool with one, but that doesn't mean that y'all are friends. Like, you don't have a group text with him. Don't answer that. You might implicate yourself in something.
No. We text. We FaceTime and text, and like, yeah, my family hate me, so I don't think I'm gonna come back in that situation. So okay.
So that goes back to you blowing it. So how does your friendship with me and Ty differ from some of your friends with like your homeboys or whatever?
Cause you can't be all emotional with your homeboys. You can. It's just you gotta pick and choose. You know who to talk to, who not to talk to. Like, I'll talk to Marcus, or like, if I'm conversating with some of the guys from my school, like, I feel like I talk to him, but like in real deep conversation about a woman or whatever, I feel more confident talking with y'all too, because y'all know me. Y'all see me grow up. Y'all know the real me. So it was like, and then like with guys, it's like we'll only tell you what we know.
Okay.
Some people be thinking totally different. Like, I was like, oh well, okay. Or like, why you do that? Why you can't be so nice? And then a girl can be like, you should show your inner side and emotions and you know, and be that person to her. And some dudes be like, yo, whatever. Dime a dozen.
So you think that we, as your female friends, help you to be more like emotionally vulnerable with your girlfriend?
Yeah, that's why I don't really talk to y'all though. Like, I don't really be asking, tell y'all about that. Cause you know, like some, like you just, you know, these Chicago women, they kind of cutthroat out here. So they
are they?
Yeah,
Southern gal.
Yeah, you gotta go in the boy playbook with them, but it's cool. But yeah, I do discuss things with y'all. Majority. I think when I find that right one and it's thinking about really taking things serious, then I'll like bring y'all in. Or like she might just fly home to North Carolina and meet people. Cause I want her to feel like if I'm in Chicago and she's in Chicago or she's from Chicago, whatever, I have access to her family. Mm-hmm. And then I want her to feel like she's like kind of hidden from my family and friends. So okay. Like that trip will have to happen regardless, sooner or later.
Mm-hmm. That's good. I appreciate that you want her to have equal access to your family and your friends like you have access to hers, since you're in closer proximity to her family.
Just sit and smile at the house.
Not just sit and smile, no. We want
to do a
deal. Wants to know the real deal. So I'm just wondering, how long into the relationship, or at what point in the relationship do you think it's appropriate for you to say, hey, I have these two friends who are girls, who I've been close to for a really long time?
See, I never like sat and said that. Like, I just be like, yeah, that's tight and everything.
We don't even warrant a whole conversation.
As I learn now, I feel like I have to warrant, like, you know, I have these two people. I have female people, whatever. Some girls try to give me a limit of like how many female friends I can have, and that's why I'm like I'm a people person. Like, just because you hateful and don't like talk to people, you know,
it's on me.
Some people, man.
Well, would you try to give your girlfriend an amount of male friends that she could have?
When it gets weird, like, I'm on the 30th dude, and, like, he's, like, conversating, then I'm going to have a problem.
Not like, the 30th. Okay, so 30 is too many.
Yeah, 30 is too many. 30, like, you don't know. I don't even know 30 people myself.
No, you're such a social person. No, I'm just wondering, but, like, what should that friendship look like? Like, is there a certain level of friendship that you think is inappropriate for your girlfriend to have?
I got to know him. I haven't seen him. I'm not looking through nobody's phone. Like, if I'm your friend and you're dating somebody and I go out with y'all or come to your house, he's there, whatever, everybody is involved in the conversation. Unless it's something private, just me and you need to talk about, like, I have an issue, whatever, then that conversation won't come out. Like, but he'll understand because he was seeing me. Like, my friend, like, she live with her boyfriend or whatever, and they have a child together. And, like, when I come over, like, we're talking all of that. Like, I made sure that I have gave that same effort to her, to him. Mm-hmm. So it's not like I'm texting or whatever. Or, like, sometimes we even call, like, at 10 o'clock, whatever, but we're two different time zones, so my 10 is her 11. Oh. But, like, she'll be talking, whatever, and, like, he'll know I'm on the phone. And I'm like, what up? And then he like, what up, whatever. Or he'll like walk by like, oh, this bro, what's up? I'm like, you got to keep it casual. Like, you can tell when somebody doing some sneaky things. Like, it ain't gonna go that far. Like,
yeah. So it's kind of like if you have a opposite sex friend, that means all of us are friends. Like, this ain't just your friend no more.
Kind of, man. If I like you, bro. Sometimes you like, like sometimes when I like you, know, like, oh, who that, Jarrell? Okay. Okay. Hey,
they got a vibe with you, man.
Yeah.
A little bit. Okay. I think I have one last question. Would you be comfortable with your girlfriend having a male friend that she confides in emotionally?
I wish we had a sensor button. See, it's tricky. That's tricky because a dude or female can use that and sway it to their advantage anytime. Like if they're a likey person, you know, you like you, whatever. Like, I don't know. If we have a conversation, like if we're having a problem, we should talk about it.
Okay.
I know that's not possible and you want to get somebody else's opinion on it or whatever, but we should conversate on it. Like, I don't know. People be plotting out here, man. I'm going to tell you. People be plotting.
That's true.
Like, they be like, nah, man, you shouldn't go up there. Like, you should take your things, get your stuff out of his house, and I'll be at 7-Eleven waiting for you when you get there. Like, they be plotting. That's why you gotta know them.
Okay, so it all goes back to knowing them.
Your gut will never prove you wrong. You will peep some stuff and be like, I'll save it for another day. Like, you will peep it, and you'll find out more just sitting in the corner and watching the whole room than saying, hey, y'all, what's going on?
Gotta sit and observe.
Yeah, you gotta sit and observe. You have to.
Okay, so it sounds like you overall think that men and women can be friends, but there have to be some boundaries in place, like don't be calling at all times of the night. You also have to know them so that you can determine, is this really your friend? They trying to slide in and do something extra? But overall, you think it's okay, as long as they don't have 30 opposite sex friends.
Yeah, I mean, like, if you will call at 11:30, I know something's wrong.
Yeah, that's true, because I will be in the bed by then.
Yeah, anyway. Like, if I call you, like, in the daytime, you automatically pick my phone because I don't really call.
Yeah.
I'll send a quick text. Like, I wouldn't understand what's wrong. Hopefully, she understands what's wrong, but, I mean, that's what you got a mouth for. You got to conversate. You gotta be mature. You gotta have somebody who's also mature. But I mean, like, people go through situations where they've been in an abusive relationship and all his friends that he said was friends was not his friends, or all her friends they say was friends, not her friends, and she just had to trust you. Just gotta be trust. You gotta have faith in the situation, like you have faith in the Lord, you just gotta trust him.
Not faith in the situation, like you have faith in the Lord. Come on now.
Girl, you love it.
Come on now.
Girl, you're not even reading the book either, girl.
I cannot with you. Okay, you got any last thoughts? I don't have any more questions.
Shoot, let me interview you real quick. Shoot, what's your opinion on it?
Who, me? No, yeah. I think that men and women can be friends. I would be a hypocrite if I said no, because we're like best friends and we've been friends for a while. But I agree, there have to be some boundaries in place. Like, I'm not about to call you at all times of the night. I don't think that I express all my deepest, darkest emotions with you, especially when I have a boyfriend, because I don't want them to think that I'm like emotionally confiding in another man. But I do think it's important for us to do what we can to make our significant others feel respected, even if we have opposite sex friends, because I would never want to do anything that makes them feel uncomfortable in the relationship. And I agree with bringing people around, because if your girlfriend spends 10 minutes with me, if my boyfriend spends 10 minutes with you, then they gonna know, I don't want you like that. We have a brother-sister relationship.
Yeah, you remember talking about at the, what was it? It was something you had at your house and your aunt came and she like stopped mid-sentence and she was like, who this?
I'm like, oh, that's Bradley. I always have to say that to people who don't know this. I'm like, oh, that's Bradley. Oh, I'm just talking to Bradley. Whatever.
I've been to every function. I've been like everybody function.
Yeah, I'm like, oh, Bradley? What about him? What about him? Yeah, so I think it's possible, but you have to be very careful. And I'm thankful that I haven't dated anybody who is uncomfortable with me having you as a friend.
Right.
So hopefully we never get there. But you gotta start at least telling people you have at least a couple opposite sex friends before they like looking at your phone and we texting you and you gonna start an argument.
See, I do after a year. You know, I gotta see how the road is. You know, I'm not play.
I say 3 months.
I see it. It just depends on the person. Like, if you know, like, they kind of iffy with things. Like, I'm telling you, like, people would be like, you can't have no female friend. I don't believe in that. Like, I'm old school, and I'm like, what is old school? Like,
what is that even? What
everybody
is
had.
I do think, though, you had a girlfriend one time who did not like you having opposite sex friends. And I was like, well, does she just want to hang out with us one time? Like, what do we need to do? And she didn't want to do anything. So I don't know. I mean, she didn't last much longer after that. But I don't know what would have happened if you would have continued dating her. Would you have cut us off? You would have just cut us off eventually.
No. I'm not cutting no good friends out. I'm sorry. Like, nah, man. You're not gonna be my friends are gonna become your friends. Like your friends are become my friends, because some of your friends are weird. Like the reason why I like these people because we mesh and they can handle my BS, I can handle theirs. It's like,
yeah, that's true.
We never had an argument.
Yeah, that is true.
Never had a disagreement argument. Like, we might disagree on something, like, something stupid I've done. But we never had, like, I hate you, and, like, I'm not texting you no more. No, that's not, I mean, I understand, like, arguments happen in friendships, but, like, if y'all can't build or whatever, was it really a friendship?
Yeah, that's so true. Yeah. Well, we'll see. Hopefully we don't have to deal with that again. Hopefully you don't even have to think about cutting us off, because, you know, you kind of stuck with us anyway.
Someone she be like, I don't like dumb life.
Sis, what's going on? Just talk to us. Talk to us. Not writing it down in your journal.
Crossing the tail off.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much, Bradley, for joining us today for a little TLC. I'm going to make sure that I include Bradley's contact information in case any of you need a graphic designer. He does a really great job. Make sure you all let us know what you think in the comments. Do you think that men and women can just be friends? Do you think we have it wrong? Do there need to be some boundaries in place? Let us know, and we look forward to seeing you next week for a little TLC.